In our three-dimensional world, particles here follow well-established rules. You're either a boson, like light, or a fermion, like electrons, protons. Two options, a very binary kind of universe, but there's a strange, flat little world where particles don't care if they're bosons or fermions, as in, I'm not this or that, I'm any. Welcome to the world of anyone's. Now, before we dive deep into this quantum rabbit hole, let's start with something a little more familiar, phonons. In quantum physics, sound isn't just a wave. It's a particle-like thing called a phonon. But phonons aren't real particles. They're what physicists call quasi-particles, which is just a fancy way of saying, we made this up, but it works. Phonons help us understand heat, sound, and why your microwave popcorn bag explodes. If phonons are weird, anyone's are rebellious. They have been observed in two-dimensional media. Recently, scientists observed emergent anyone behavior in a one-dimensional ultra-cold bosonic gas for the first time. Different from 3D world in 2D, all bets are off. Anyone say, why pick a side? I can be one-third boson plus two-thirds fermion, or whatever I feel like today. If regular particles are he or she, then an anyone says, I'm particle non-binary. Respect my fractional statistics. They're not breaking the laws of physics. They're just operating in a legal system that's only valid in Flatland. Beyond their fabulous quantum identity, anyone's might just save the future of computing. You see, traditional quantum bits, qubits, are fragile. They decohere, get messed up by tiny vibrations, or by your neighbor sneezing in Australia. But anyone's are different. Their information isn't stored in a state. It's stored in a path. It's like tying a knot in space-time itself. You can braid anyone's around each other. And depending on how they move, they store different values. That's not just cool. That's topological quantum computing, aka the kind of computer that can handle problems we can't even define yet. Picture this. Two anyones appear. You move one around the other in a circle. From the outside, nothing changes. But deep inside the math, the universe whispers, I saw what you did there. The wave function, the particle's very identity, shifts. This means anyone-based computation is inherently protected from noise. It's like quantum encryption with built-in error correction. Their implications stretch across dimensions, from condensed matter labs to quantum computers, and maybe even into questions of identity, order, and chaos. Let's zoom out. What even is a particle? Is it something real or just a tool we made up to make sense of motion and math? Are quasi-particles ripples in some higher dimensional space? If you had the choice, would you rather be a stable, predictable fermion, or an identity fluid anyone twisting through time with style? Thanks for watching. Give it a like if this video rearranged your understanding of reality.